Okay, so four parts to the barrel turn. The horse's nose has to be out. He has to be able to lift his shoulders. He has to be able to bend, and he has to be able to stop. Now, this stop is not a reining horse stop. It's not a cutting horse stop. It's a combination of both. The reining horse moves forward through his stop. The cutter stops, comes back through his stop. But the cutter's shoulders are up with the nose out, and the reiners have their nose tucked to the chest. So we have to get in middle ground here. That's the tough train about training these barrel horses to stop correctly. It's not an easy train, and it's not an easy thing to do. So I'm always working my horses' stops. Don't care how far along they are, from a 3-year-old to a 13-year-old. They're always working on their stops. Some horses come to you, they're more natural to the stop. Other horses, you got to train that stop to them. But you can't quit working the stop. The stop is critical. It's the foundation to the turn, the stop. It's how they stop and turn that wins for you. So what am I looking for? When I stop this horse, I'm going to train her to stop. I'm going to go in some circles. When her body gets straight on that fence, I'm going to ask her to stop. Right now, I'm not going to stop her. I'm not going to stop her. I'm going to stop her when her body goes straight. Right there. Back her up a step or two. Kick her, click her. The easier your horses will back up, the more they're breaking the pole when you back them up, the better your stops. Again, I let her body get straight on that stop as we're starting to train her to stop. I might do it on a trot, and I might do it in the same place every day, because then they'll start to anticipate and they'll start to look for the stop. Oh. Back a step. Go again. I'll stop her right exactly in the same place. So they start anticipating stop. That's good. They're starting to train herself to stop. Same place. Whoa. Remember, when you stop this barrel horse, a lot of it comes from your mouth. That means whoa. There might be 3 or 4 whoas in an approach. There might be 1 whoa, or there might be a soft whoa, but there's always a whoa on your barrels. Don't neglect to ask your horse to stop with your mouth. If I'm going to prepare this horse to stop, I first touch her with my hands, get her body straight, then I ask her with my mouth, and then I pull on my rein to stop her. She comes around this time around here. She'll get straight to the fence. I gather her. Whoa. I just lightly gather her. And then I stop her. Again, I'm working this mare in a school to wind bridle. It breaks them in the pole real nice. Puts a lot of stop on your horses. Breaks them back into your hands. Gets them into your hands. I like to work the shoulders and I like to work the stops in this bridle here. You don't lean back when you stop the barrel horse. If you lean back, you're going to drive him forward. That's why reiners sit back so far, as they're driving their horse forward through that stop. You can't lock your knees and bounce up over the front of the horse either. So you try to ride the stop with your quads. Your quads are right here. Your knees are bent. You keep your feet away from that horse. Whoa. Don't give it this stuff. Do not lock your knees like that. Put your feet forward and stop that horse that way, because you're going to send them forward through that stop like a reiner does. That's not what we're looking for. We're trying to create some stop here. The other way I'll train this horse to stop is I'll let the environment help me stop this horse. So I'm going to lope on down to that. I'll lope on down to this corner here. As I get closer, she's going to want to stop. Well, I don't have to do much other than ask her to stop, because there's nowhere for her to go but to the corner. I'm going to ride her to this corner. Just keep riding her into the corner. Ride her, ride her, ride her. Well, to stop, she's got more to go. I'll send her on down. Always back after that stop. The other thing I school on my horses to do is bend their nose and stop. So I'll lift her shoulder into that fence. Whoa. That way, they get used to stopping with their nose bent. As we're going to a barrel, you keep that shoulder up by bending the nose. they don't have to straighten out their body to stop. So I'll keep her shoulder up this fence. Same thing going down here. Keep this shoulder up. Whoa. Now again, a barrel horse is forward in the stop, not like a cutter, because they come back through themselves, but not so much like a reiner that keeps sliding. You got to stop. You got to make that stop and go forward at the same time. It's an oxymoron, and it's a tough train. One of the tougher parts about training a barrel horse, it's a lot tougher to get your stops correct as opposed to lifting a shoulder.